What is it what I don't want?
You fake dishes.
So this is a Stonehenge machine, right?
Yeah.
You've got your U-shaped gully.
So bit of routing. Yeah.
Down the edge, routed out. You've got your ovioles. There's a set of holes called X and Y in the middle.
Is that where the blue stones are?
Well, that's what they represent.
Yeah.
That's what they represent. I think they're the blue stones.
Yeah.
So fill your boots. Don't drop any. In there. This is a load of balls. As well as put them in your gully there.
Inside and out.
Place your bets, please. Place your bets.
They had them carved stone balls, the Scottish, along with the kilts. They also had plain balls as well. If it doesn't work.
Don't
step back. Don't lose them in the field.
That game the Japanese play where they flick a ball up all the time.
Ping-tong.
Mahjong?
No. It's something like a pinball or something. Like a pinball machine.
Yeah,
you've got some left over.
You just said that before.
Did you? So you said, have you got enough, you said.
Yeah, and he said.
And he said, we'll have some left over. So I just said, yes, I'll have some left over. Mm-hmm. We don't listen.
Have a look at that one now. And we've got now, there's two.
Turntable.
There's a barrow. There's a north and south barrow on Stonehenge. So there's two barrows there and there.
Yeah.
Well, they call them barrows, but I think they were inspection. Yeah, we come near Vanessa and just visit video the and see the. It's for taking the balls out when they broke.
Oh right.
So say they have a broken one, they can put a new. They'll take a broken one out there, and as it comes round, somebody else will drop a new one in.
Good accuracy, Steve.
Brilliant.
I'm sure the Neolithic. Well, it was Stone Age and it was Wood Age as well. They had a wood end, didn't they?
Outside up, yeah.
That side up. Oh, is that it? No, it's got to be turned around because it's not matching, see?
Well, so,
take this
lift
one.
It up. Come this way, go that way.
I feel like the plank.
You're in the wrong way now.
The plank.
Sykes.
Let's stand down a bit.
So I think in the Stonehenge they have like an avenue. So I think this represents the avenue.
Yeah.
Hey, this last of the summer wine, take two. This is the second experiment, weeks later. The first one, we made a big mistake.
Right.
I didn't bolt the machine together.
No, we didn't.
So when we were spinning it around, it looked like we were holding it. No, we did bolt it together later on, but we'll let that go. But these things, these are add-ons or improvisations just to try and keep the feet straight.
Right.
And I've also made one of these. Remember the round the balls?
Oh, yeah.
So can you see that?
Yeah.
So I think what they did, I'm going to use a magnet, but they tied a string around it, didn't they, and hooked it out. So we'll take it, we'll pull it out with a magnet. Now the Egyptians greased their machine with what you call a wax cone. They used to put it on their head, believe it or not.
Yeah.
Because they needed both they needed both hands free.
How did they stop it falling off their head?
With wax. Melt the wax.
Actually stick it on the head.
Stick it on the head.
Oh, right.
That's why there was a lot of bald Egyptians.
probably why they shaved their heads. So I made this I made this 2 years ago, this grease.
Good grief.
And put it inside this wax thing.
But is it chamois leather?
No, it's just cloth and I put wax on the cloth.
Yeah.
And then I put a beeswax base on
it. Yeah, stop it coming out.
Stop it coming out to seal the bottom. And then I would imagine they just heat the bottom and whack it on the head.
Right.
And then they've got two hands free, haven't they?
You could do a Tommy Trinder.
Well, what's her name? A makeup artist. She puts grease on the back of her hand, doesn't she?
Yeah,
so it's only put you only put it on your head. Yeah. It's not. So this goes in there.
With a little lubrication.
Little lubrication. That's right, Al. You didn't say
action.
Action. Okay. Action. I know this weighs. You're right, Al. You take the weight.
Which side do you want to go? That side.
Yeah, it's 58 kilos, this. Do you know why I know?
That's
what it said on the bill. This is 2.4, so 1.2 is in the centre. So that's the centre of the plank there. So what we've got to do now is counterbalance the machine. So if you pull this towards you, just tilt. Pull this machine, just this end. Just show this end, come back down. A bit too easy. Just back to me a tad. Okay, so we've tied the load to the machine and we need to get the machine level so it doesn't tip over, really. So we've put bricks under the back under the back of the feet, and under both. The machine's level. If you want to come and just have a quick look at the spirit level, see there, and it's level that way near enough anyway. So it's when we spin it round, level there now, so we can lift it up. Okay, so we've done 4 meters in, I don't know, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, maybe a bit more. Is it easy to lift?
Yeah.
Do it again then. Okay. Is it very heavy?
Yeah.
Okay, let's take it over to the shed and weigh it then.
12.3 kg.
Okay. Okay, can you move it left and right, yeah? Okay, put it down. Turn it round now. Left and right again.